Welcome back to Computer Vision. Today we're going to continue on our long and winding excursion through tracking. And in particular, what we're going to do today is we're going to revisit the whole notion of Bayes-based filter tracking or Bayesian tracking sort of develop a method that allows us to do that well. So you remember the tracking with dynamics, right? So the whole idea was, because we're tracking something that's moving with respect to the imagery, we're going to learn something about the dynamics and use the dynamics in order to make predictions. And we're doing this so that we can limit the area of search that we're looking in, and also so that we can get a better total estimate when we're done, under the assumption that the things we were trying to track, you can't perfectly detect them, and it's noisy to begin with. And we're basically making an assumption that there's some sort of smooth motion going on, and that essentially our dynamics don't surprise us is the underlying element. So last time we developed what was called the Kalman filter. And the Kalman filter was for linear dynamic systems, where you had Gaussian noise context. So what we meant by that was the motion could be predicted by a linear factor applied to the motion that you've estimated, and then you add in some Gaussian noise if you were thinking about what the uncertainties are. Same thing with our measurements. They were a linear function of the state, and then there was some noise. And what was nice about it is everything, prediction, correction, your lunch break, it's all Gaussian. All right? And so the only thing you have to do is maintain the mean and the covariances of these Gaussians. And it just works in 1D or ND, et cetera. It's real easy. And the calculations are pretty straightforward also. I mean, the equations looked a little ugly, but it's just a bunch of matrix multiplies and a couple of inverses.